Respected Sir Guruji, the captains of the CREDAI, delegates who have come from different parts of the country, friends, brothers and sisters, I'm extremely sorry. I came around at 10 minutes late. That never happens. There is a traffic jam, of course. That also cannot be excused. We are responsible for the same. We are trying to remove these traffic jams everywhere. Not only in Delhi, not only in the road traffic, but also other traffics also. It will take some time. It will take some time. Friends, I really feel happy to be at this today. And I was telling you that I have been with you earlier also. The timing of the CREDAI conference somehow, I don't know why Geetha Bharji and Vikshay and Paul and all, they have put it now. Our minds are somewhere. Because just now we focus telling about donkeys. Yes. Donkeys, now I learned another thing. I used to believe that donkeys are truthful, faithful, but he also said they are also smart. So, I am very happy to hear that. Secondly, he was also talking about having some peace of mind. That's why Sadhguru is here. To give you peace of mind. Sadhguru, do Sadhbuddhi to all of us. That is the purpose of Sadhguru's being invited and going around. Not only to you people, to all of us, including politicians. He, Mr. Sridharji and also one were worried about the image that's being attributed. There will be. Today we have election. We are all politicians. Even one politician does, not many people say politicians, but all you just fellow, they are also politicians. They don't perform what they do. And we have politicians who commit rape, molestation, still be ministers, in spite of the highest court giving order, and become again denominated. And then police goes. Today I saw the statement of a police officer stunning State Inspector General saying that it is better not to touch the minister. The minister touches a woman, no problem. The police should not touch the minister. And then, in spite of Supreme Court order, we are not airports, ports. There is no need to go to airport and port. Very easy, everybody knows. Concerned people at least. Friends, so there will be some interaction always, every sphere of public life. We should live up to our expectations. And then we should try to keep up the image and prestige of the profession which we are all involved. That's the only thing. Otherwise, we, people like us, who are added to some ideology of politics, would have run away from politics because of criticism that's being made, comments that's being made, but also messages that we receive. We are doing our best. That's the confidence, but every day we always introspect and then try to move forward. Friends, after ERA, GST, remonetization, infrastructure status to affordable housing, and a slew of other policy and legal measures, including fiscal concessions granted in the budget 2016 and budget 2017, and the announcement made by Prime Minister on 31st December, the real estate sector is raring to go ahead. I'm sure about it. The reforms have been strategically crafted and time to perform, capitalizing on the reforms. Because PM gave me three-line mantra that applies to all. He said, reform, perform, and transform. Then I told him as the IMP minister, sir, I will add one more line. Reform, perform, transform, then I will inform as the IMP minister. So friends, sir, there is a lot of change and development going on in the country. Things are moving, things are changing. So the real estate sector also, it must move away from that image which is created by few fly-by-night operators, and see to it that we, the real estate sector also gets a very good name. Having done, this will transform the real estate sector, but for that to happen, developers need to change their outlook and also mindset and come out with the new business principles and models. I say so because over the last 2 years, the government has done so much for this important sector and paid more attention than any other sector of the economy. I am not saying that I have done some favor to you. Who am I and who are you? We are all together. We are all partners in the development of the country, and this government believes that public, private, that difference has to be now cleared. We are all together. After all, private people, and we are allowing a BIA, foreign countries, allowing on China also. What is the problem in working with the private sector? So this government do not believe in that theory. There are people and politicians who condemn the business in the day and do business with them in the night. We don't believe in it. Business and agriculture are like two ways of human. We must take care of both of them. That's why we have no hesitation in taking some of the initiatives which are regarded pro-business also. No problem. Business also is there for the welfare of the country, for the development of the country. And you people who are in the business, you do your business well, then it really benefits the country and it benefits the government also. So we have no hesitation and we don't feel shy to talk to the business. This would enable much desired ecosystems required in the sector to put aside legacy issues and also move ahead with a new perspective to make most of the virtue, not only at the bottom of the pyramid and also even the middle of the pyramid also. The new ecosystem that I am talking about is based on C's. One is character, second is credibility, third one is confidence, and fourth one is cash. Cash is the last. First of all, character, credibility, and confidence. Friends, the fact that this critical sector over the years have acquired such a degree of attain for several reasons we are all aware of it. So there is a series of crisis of character. The Real Estate Liberation Development Act that has been made reality after a long delay of 8 years seeks to restore the character of the sector. The Binami Transactions Prevention Act will further complement this in this regard. RERA Act has boosted the entire industry and is definitely proving to be a game changer for the real estate sector. Eliminate fly-by-night operators from the sector while promoting the genuine developers. Infuse transparency and accountability and ensure timely project completion. Government is not asking you to do anything more than what you have promised. What you have promised on paper, you just complete that. Will stand by you. There will be problems. I know that after this, the Real Estate Regulation Act comes into force, and after May 2017, when the regulators are appointed in the various states, the issue of the approvals is also an important aspect, because you will not be able to perform your responsibility favor. Please. The problem is of performing the commitment. For that you need permissions. So permissions are there with the state government, with the local body also, with other central government agencies. I had a meeting with several of my colleagues 9 times for ease of approvals. And I'm sure all this civil aviation, defense ministry, railway ministry, consumer affairs ministry, and also the environment ministry, more importantly, and culture ministry because of ASI and all of us sat together for 9 times, and finally we are going to make a presentation before Prime Minister of Patri, and then we all these things will become a matter of past, and the early approvals will be given to the extent possible. But you need not come to Delhi. Number of times for the permission for various things that is happening. We have made a beginning with Delhi, made a beginning with Mumbai, two major metropolitan cities, and I want to see the last local body also to ease up approvals, online approvals, and at the end of the day, time fixed, 30 days or 60 days, whatever finally emerges, you apply, get a reply, otherwise deemed to have been approved. That should be the policy. Friends, once we acquire positive character, it will lead to credibility, and this will translate into much required confidence of buyers. Yesterday I was in a CREDAI property show in Visakhapatnam. I am a student of Visakhapatnam University, and I was going to the college campus, of number of cars there. I asked them what is happening, why so many cars Visakhapatnam, the entire Visakhapatnam cream has come there. They said CREDAI property show. That shows the sector is moving. I went around, I spent some time, though there was no schedule to visit that, and I was there in Visakhapatnam for some other program. Election. That's our problem. I told you, our mind. We have, in this country, we have festival of elections. Normally, there are fixed festivals, but there are, these festivals are not fixed. When the festival come, nobody knows. Every time, 3 months, 6 months, then election, then three-point program, election, then selection, and then correction, and then group, and then election. Three politicians were preoccupied. That's why the Prime Minister is much concerned. Prime Minister is requested all political parties to come together to have simultaneous elections. In one go, within 1 week or 10 days or 15 days, assembly, parliament, municipality, all things should be completed. So that there is time, 5 years time to work, to deliver, and also to be answerable. Otherwise, every time this, you can't take any hard decision. Then everybody will be trying to populistic only. Populism is pauperism. The Prime Minister and we believe, we don't want to be populistic, populism. We believe in peopleism. What is in the interest of the people in the long term, that is the policy of the government. So friends, the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana provides a huge opportunity. Earlier it was confined only to poorer sections, economically weaker sections, low income groups. Now it has been extended also. Now we have huge middle class in the form of interest subsidy and tax and other concessions and relaxations have been given in the budget. For a long time we have been demanding infrastructure status for housing sector. Keeping faith in me, you wanted and expected me to take up with the government. I talked to my colleagues here, Arun Jaitley. I'm thankful to him also. For this forum also, I want to thank him for that finally in this budget, this affordable housing infrastructure status has been given. Thanks to the Honorable Prime Minister. The matter reached up to the Prime Minister and finally the decision has been taken. For information, friends, the committee. Institutional mechanism on harmonized list of infrastructure subsectors deliberated on the implementation of infrastructure status for affordable housing recently and decided to issue necessary notification also. The announcement of infrastructure status for affordable housing in the recent budget would go a long way in placing more cash in the hands of home buyers. This will act as a catalyst for the growth of affordable housing projects in the market. Direct tax, as per the recommendations of the industry, my ministry pursued with the Ministry of Finance on various tax concessions for this sector. Section 81BA concession has been extended to project of 30 by 60 square of carpet area from built-up area. It's a major concession that has been given. The time limit for completion has been extended from 3 to 5 years. That is also an important item. Joint development agreements have been given a breather. Long-term capital asset definition has been made more business friendly. On that, there were some suggestions. We are discussing those suggestions also given by our friends. Tax on notional income on inventory stocks has been given a relaxation. GST. GST is part of the theme of this conference. Though there is no clarity on the inclusion of real estate within the ambit of GST, there is no denying the likely benefit that would accrue to the sector by becoming part of this big bang reform, one nation, one tax. So one big advantage of GST is going to bring the industry, the cascading of taxes, that is tax and tax, would become a thing of the past. I am sure the Finance Minister and the GST Council are deliberating in this regard and they will finally come to some useful conclusions. Input tax credit would be available. Thus, there is a huge incentive to bring all transactions in real estate sector within the formal system to enjoy creditors. What is happening? Recently, there is a lot of discussion about demonetization or remonetization. Some people call it a note bandi. I don't say word bandi, it says note badri. Note badri. That has happened and people expected something will happen. Some people from the constitutional forums also said there will be riots in the country. To the disappointment, nothing will happen in the country also. 15 days, the people to draw their own money, they had to go for some suffering. But still, I salute their perseverance, the common man's perseverance in the country. They stood by the Prime Minister because they believe the Prime Minister, his character, caliber, capacity, and conduct, and credibility. They stood by the nation, they stood by the nation of the government. And today, some people from my friends, I can be frank with you, they are all saying, what is it you have achieved, sir? 15 lakh crores, or 14 lakh crores, or 16 lakh crores, or come back to bank. We wanted the money to come back to bank. Not to lay in alvaras or the bedrooms or bathrooms or the underground alvaras. The money has to come. Money has to come. You need to sleep on money. You can sleep on your bank account happily. That's where you'll get peace. If you have money under your bed, you'll not be able to have a proper sleep also. The The money has come back. पैसा वापस आया. मगर पैसा पता के साथ वापस आया. उसका पिता के साथ वापस आया. उसका पति के साथ भी वापस आया. वो है इसका मालिक. मालूम हो गया. The money has come back with the address. So it's being verified. And for that also some people have objection. What is the problem about it? You have been sent a notice to those people, and then you have to explain it's your money, that you are the owner. You are the owner, you are the husband, or you are the father, or you are the guardian of that money. That's all. Mispeluke putloka avati hai. Because the criticism was more political than realistic. But I've seen recently where the world famous economics column writer, the London Financial Times, I think Wolf Martin, he wrote two pieces and he said if you pursue the way, because the world economy slowed down, China also is going negative. We must have seen 25 years low, 6.5. We don't enjoy that. I'm just giving a reference, 6.5. So he said if you pursue proper policies, the same way you move together, the day is not far off, India will be able to push back China and move forward. That's the substance of the article written by Mr. Wolf Martin in London Academic Times, Financial Times. So I'm sure friends, some of you might have already read it. Input tax credit would be available, and then there is a huge incentive to bring all transactions in the real estate sector. Let every transaction be transparent, then nothing to worry. The friends, these laws, GST laws, once passed by Parliament, and respective states are likely to usher in implementation of the GST from 1st July 2017. I'm conscious of the concerns of the industry, the service of GST. However, I assure you that GST will not lead to an increase of prices and certainly not for the affordable housing segment. I will be arguing your case with the finance minister and also trying to convince you. Currently, affordable housing is exempt from service tax. My ministry has already taken up with the Ministry of Finance the need to continue with this exemption even under GST also. I have also written to the finance minister. We have also recommended to the Ministry of Finance to tax the sector at a rate which is revenue neutral and not at a higher tax rate than the existing. That also I have taken up with the Minister and I wrote a letter to him also. One of the industry demands has been to see that to include a stamp duty under GST. However, we are all aware the states have their own wisdom not adhered to the inclusion of stamp duty under GST. They did not agree. They said this is our power. The GST Constitutional Amendment Act does not provide for it. Thus, we need to move forward on this from this debate. We have taken up with the state government to rationalize the stamp duty. I have written to all the chief ministers also to reduce the stamp duty, rationalize it also. And of course, we have been asking for waiver of stamp duty for the affordable housing. At the end of the day, the states have to take a call depending on their economic situation. RERA and GST are steps to ensure transparency in the real estate sector and direct tax concessions. The big sentiment boost. We should capitalize on this opportunity to make it a world-class industry. Withdrawal of high-value currency notes announced in the last November 8th was a primary behavioral change. It's not a behavioral change. There is a need for change of mindset. There is a need for change of behavior also from top to bottom. That's happening. I'm sure the real estate sector also will understand the spirit of the government's move and try to go for it. Friends, there is a saying that 20 to 30% of the money in this real estate sector is paid unaccounted. I am not entering into the figures, I don't know. Till yesterday, payment by money was legal. So you cannot find fault with them. But real estate in certain areas have not affected the real state of affairs. Real estate and real estate. Because the land prices have been chopped up like this and then making it practically impossible to make houses in an affordable manner. So we have to really introspect. Whoever is meeting me, I am telling them the rates in Vijayawada, rate in Hyderabad, rate in Bangalore and all, they are equal to New York or other big cities, Paris and all, because of the land prices. So land price has gone to sky. It has to drop down to land. The land price has to drop down to the land. That is the only way. That we need your cooperation also. Let us not go for over competition and unnecessary create demand and then so that these prices are going up and then you have to add it and the price of the construction along with the food cost also is going up. Friends, there is some misgotten money is there, but now slowly it's all coming into the system. And this has resulted in a price distortion, making it difficult for the common man and the honest to realize their continue on basic aspects of owning a house. After the era, I get number of messages in my who are talking of some small people. No, no, big names are there in that. Big names have been there in the market. People really bust their greed, their concern. They ask the government to PD. Now they are finding part of the government. What is it you have done? What is the benefit of having this act? This Noida it happened like this. Ghaziabad happened like this. Delhi is happening like this. Prime Minister and everyone knows these are the things that are happening now. I cannot totally tell them I am helpless. At the same time, there has to be some mechanism. So the sector also must take care of such a private net operator. You have to liberate voluntary code of conduct, and also educating your own members and also creating awareness among the society. These are some of the solutions. So friends, Real Estate Act, GST, industry status, tax concessions, and the note withdrawal will address these legacy issues to a large extent, and coming days it is going to be mostly digital transfer. So I request all of you, I was suggesting to Rakshay, by the time he takes charge, he must, he was requesting you to come there, you must come out with a declaration that all the transactions are going to be digital. If you can give me that much assurance, I'll be more than happy. That will really improve. That will really improve the health of the nation and also add to the wealth of the nation. Health and wealth, they go together. If we have health, if we have wealth and no health, you know what is. You have laddus in front of you, can't eat because you are diabetic. And if you have only health, then you can add wealth also. So the sector needs to follow healthy traditions, and I can tell you the digital transfer is one such thing. More cooperation becoming bankable in a cashless economy. Thus more housing loans will be disbursed by banks and housing finance corporations. Note withdrawal was not a temporary interlude. Its adverse impacts, if any, have been short-lived, and in the long term, it is beneficial for the entire system. The third quarter revised GDP numbers by the CSO have also confirmed the same. More than me, all of you are aware that the real estate sector has been passing through difficult for over 3 years, as I told you, because of land prices and also non-availability of the credit. Banks not showing enthusiasm to lend loans for this real estate sector. These are the realities. But now banks also are with money. They are looking for reliable customers. If you can prove to be credible, then definitely you will get money, and with this affordable status, infrastructure status for the affordable housing, that will make more money available in the sector. So in the new ecosystem, I referred earlier, all the junior developers need to rise to the occasion to position the real estate sector on a path of sustainable growth. Since Roofing India now offers immense opportunities. So friends, I don't want